Hi and hello dear friends, welcome back once again to our channel Vagai Academy of Mathematics. So this session we have the question paper of 2016 July NTA UGC NET paper 1, and here we are about to solve questions under the category data interpretation. Yeah, fine. So here we are given a table actually, and based on this information given in this table, we have a set of questions given below. We should answer those questions. First of all, let's just see what is given here in this table. So we have rows and columns. So row wise, we have different varieties or different styles of music. So there are 7 types of music available, like classical, pop, rock, jazz, and so on, like this. And column wise, if we take, we have age categorized, like 15 to 20, we have in the first column. Then 21 to 30, we have the second column, and 31 plus we have in the third column. So this represents the number of people of this age varieties, age categories. So this is what we are given in this table. Now let's try to, first of all, get the total number of people here. How many are here? Overall total, what's the overall total? Let's try to get that total first of all, for which let's try to get the columns total. So let's take the first column, 15 to 20. Here we have this total to be, this total we'll be getting it as, yeah, let's total it. 6 plus 7, 13, 13 plus 6, 19 plus 1, 20, 22, 22 plus 11, we have 33 here. And next is 21 to 30. Let's come to the second column. Here we have 4 plus 5, 9, plus 12, 21. Then we have 25, 28, 28 plus 5. Once again, we have 33 here. And coming to the last column, we have 17, 5, 22, 22 plus 14. We have 22 plus 14 to be 36, then 47, then we have 62 and 68. Yeah, we got the total here. Yes. Now, in order to get the overall total, what we must do is we'll just add up these values so that we'll get the overall total. So that would be 66 plus 68, that would be 4. 1 will be a carry, 6 plus 6 plus 1 will be 13. So 134, this 134 is going to be the overall total here. And now it would be better for us to get into the questions. So yeah, coming to the questions now, we'll take the first question. So our first question is, approximately what percent of the total sample indicates that hip hop is their favorite style of music? So here we are asked to calculate the percentage of, out of the total, we need to find the total, we need to find the percentage of this hip hop category. So this is what is asked in the first question. So we just calculated the overall total to be 134. Let's make a note of it. And out of which we need the hip hop's total. So coming back to the table, let's see this hip hop row. So we need to find the total number of people here under this hip hop category. So we have 9 plus 3 plus 4. That would be giving us 16, is it or not? Because 9 plus 3 would be 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. So then that means out of 134, this 16 is how much percentage? This is our question. So in order to find the percentage, we need to just multiply this fraction by 100. That would give the answer. But rather than simplifying and calculating this, we'll just try to get the answer through approximation process. That would be a better way for us. So let's take the number 134. This is the total we know very well. And for this 134, let's try to see what percentage of this 134 would be approximately 16. So once we achieve it, we'll be able to get the answer. So it's very clear, 10% of my number is 13.4, right? Because our total is 134. 10% of that number would be 13.4, just one decimal point I'm just keeping. So 13.4. Yes, so it's very clear that our 16 is definitely more than 13.4. In that case, my answer has to be definitely more than 10%. In that case, options 1 and 2 cannot be our answer. So we have the other two options to be 12% and 14%. The least among them is 12%. So let's go for 2 more percentage. Let's go for 2% of our number. So 2% of our number would be actually, we know that 1% will be 1.34. So 1% will be 1.34. Yes. So from which we can easily calculate what is 2%. 2% would be double of that. So 1.34 into 2 will give us 2.68. And now let's just add it so that we'll be getting what is 12% of our number. I hope you are able to follow this. So we are checking that whether option 4, that is 12%, can be our answer to the question. That's what we are checking here. So 10%, we calculated it to be 13.4. And just adding 2% with that, how we are adding it? So we calculate what is 1%, it's 1.34, double it. We get 2.68, which is 2%. So now when we add 10 plus 2, we get 12%. So which would be 0.8 and a 1 carry. So it's 16. It's very near to what we need here. Yeah, 16. So in that case, 16 is actually around 12% of our number. So approximately it's 12%. So option 4 is matching with our answer. Option 4, 12% is the answer to our first question. I hope how we are able to reach the answer. You're able to understand how we are reaching the answer through this kind of approximation process. Yes, fine. Let's move on to the second question. Question number 2, we have what percentage of the respondents aged 31 plus? Be clear with the words, how they are using. What percentage of the respondents aged 31 plus indicated a favorite style other than classical music? So that is here, out of the people who are under the age category 31 plus, how many are indicating a favorite style other than classical? The word is very important, other than classical. So yes. So in that case, here we should be going for the total. Here the total value is 31 plus. Is it or not? Yes, 31 plus. So just now in the beginning of the session, we have calculated the 31 plus total. 31 plus total is 68 actually. So that means out of 68, how many are indicating this out of classical? That is other than classical. That's the question. So let's go for an approach like, let's see how much is this classical. Classical is actually 17, right? So out of 68 people, 17 of them are going for classical. Yeah, 17. So let's do a thing. Let's just try to calculate this classical's percentage. So classical's percentage would be nothing but that 17 out of 68 as a percentage. So it's very easy to calculate, right? Because 17 ones are 17 and 17 fours are 68. So in that case, 1/4 of 100 would be 25%. So that means we are getting the answer to be 25% for which category? For classical. But our question is, what percentage is for other than classical? So it's very obvious that if classical is 25%, then other than classical would be its complement, which would be nothing but 75%. It's very easy to understand, right? Because we are going to reach the answer in the reverse process. Like we are asked to find what is other than classical. Instead, what we do is we just try to find what is classical's percentage. We are ending up with 25%. So that means other than classical would be just 100 minus that 25%, which would be 75%. And yes, option 3, 75% is the answer. I hope you are able to understand this question also, the way we are solving it. Let's go for the last question. Question number 3 we have. Question number 3. Here, our question is, what percentage of the total sample were aged 21 to 30? So once again, here the question is like, out of total 21 to 30, this category is how much? So total, we are clear with the total. We have already used the total. Yes, total is 134 here. So 134 out of 134, how many are from 21 to 30 category? Let's see, 21 to 30. Yeah, it's there in the second column, right? So 21 to 30. Yeah, there are 33 people here. So that means our question is very simple. Out of these 134 people, this 33 people will make what percentage? So it's just 33 by 134 into 100. So once again, let's try to handle this question also. Find the answer to this question also through approximation process. So like our number is 134, which we'll just go for 50%. 50% is exactly half of our number. So that means it would be 67. Because half of 134 is 67. And what is 25%? 25% will be still half of this 50. So that means 67 is half. So what is half of 67? It would be 33.5. Yeah, we have came very near. So that means our number 33, which is exactly matching with this 33.5, like very near. It's very much, much, much near. So in that case, our approximate value for this one would be 25%, no doubt in that. So yes, option 3, 25% is our answer to this question. And you may have a doubt about the other options, because 23, you can see the option 23% is again very very closer to 25%. But when we come calculate this 23%, it will be definitely much lower than what we are expecting. So always it's better to go for the very nearest answer choice. So in that case, 25% is the answer for this question. Yes, done. So we have completed all the three questions from this set. I hope you are able to understand all the questions. If you see, all these three questions were based on the percentage calculations. So that's what is really important. And at the same time, it is also better if we perform these calculations through some approximation process so that we can very easily reach the answers. That's the thing. Yeah, fine. Yeah. I hope you are clearly able to understand how the way we are solving all these questions here in this session. And yes, if any doubts you can sure, let us know through the comment box. And yes, let's catch up in the next session with some other set of questions. See you soon there. Thank you so much. Bye.